So I want to say, like, I want to say, if you guys see, okay, if I see, and then I want to say something like, hey, and then the usual form of this guy is like, for example, I think I would say, I have a square, plus a square, a square. Then what is the trigonometric change that I have to do? So my trigonometric change is going to be x equals 2. I need to get rid of this a to be able to factor out the b, right? So I'm going to say my x is going to be given by b over a. And then I need a formula that gives me, after I factor out this, that b, I'm going to get 1 plus. Okay, so what happens to this? Let me put it here. So, no linkage over here. So, if I have b squared plus a squared a, then I need to put more stuff here. But I want you to tell me what I need here. So, if I plug in these positions, b over a, instead of my x, I'm going to have b squared plus a squared times b over a, and then I'm going to put something here, a square, correct? All this is inside the square root. And then when I square these things, then I'm going to have b squared plus a squared b squared over a squared and something here, a square. Now this a, I'm going to be able to cancel out, yes? I'm going to be able to factor out a b. I'm going to have b squared 1 plus, I don't know, something here squared. And then this b is going to go up. So I'm going to have b square root of 1 plus something squared. And I want an identity here that lets me get rid of this miserable square root, right? So what is that? I know that 1 plus tangent squared is equal to 2. It equals 2.
Secant squared.
So when I see b squared plus a squared times x squared, my change of coordinate should be b over a secant of theta. Right? Because then I go 1 plus tangent is secant, right? It's just tangent, okay, right? Because when I put it over there, if I put my tangent over here, tangent squared of theta, 1 plus tangent squared is equal to secant squared. So I can replace all these 1 plus by secant squared. And then the square root of that is just going to be b times secant of theta, correct? Yes? So you see what I mean? Why am I using a knee like that? You're supposed to know this because he said he covered this part. Okay? Now, this is not the only possibility. This is one possibility. Now there is another possibility, b. What if instead of a plus here, I have a minus? Okay? What if I have a minus here? So now I'm going to have this. B squared minus A squared X squared. What is my change of coordinate? So as you understand from this computation, I have to have B over A. X has to be equal to B over A. Of course, I'm not thinking that A is zero, right? Because it doesn't make sense. If A is zero, then what am I doing here? Just get a square root of B and that's it. So, what should be the thing that I have to put here instead of tangent? Because tangent is not going to work. What will work? Huh?
cosine?
Exactly, sine of cosine. For example, I'm going to say sine of theta. Why is he saying that? Because now, all what I have to go is change a minus here. Instead of a plus, I have a minus. Now, he told me I have to use sine of theta. Then it becomes a minus. I have a sine of theta over here. This is a minus. I have a sine square of theta over here. And what do I know? That 1 minus sine square of theta is equal to cosine of theta. So I'm going to have here a beautiful cosine square of theta. And the square root of that is going to be b cosine of theta, which is something that I can go through. Correct? Yes? So this is very easy to deal with. Now, if I have another case, and then I finish the okay? Sonso, Maragui. So I'm going to, we're going to solve right now problem 11 in section 5.7. So this is section 5.7, problem 11. And it says like this. It says, find the integral over square root of 9 minus x squared over x squared dx. Okay, so you don't need a book. You just need to see a problem. And then my little question is going to be, what is the substitution that I have to do? Yes? And then I'm going to give you some feedback. Okay, my center coordinates should be 3, x equals to 3, and I just use all what I have there. 3 tangent of theta. B equals x equals to 3 sine of theta, and then C equals to 3 sine of theta. Okay, little question. So let's open that. Okay, so maybe choose your change of coordinates. It's a critical moment, right? I only want to know what it is the edge that I have to take. Okay, so I don't want you to solve that for integral. Are we done? Then why is it the integral? I need. Come on. Like a 3 times 3 is 9 divided by 9 is 1. So I'm going to get cosine of theta. Okay. I'm going to simplify it like this and let me know if is this clear. Okay, that was too fast. Too fast? Okay, slower.
My problem started with x, and now all what I have here is 10
recommending, so I have to go back to X. How do I go back to X? I have to solve over here. So this is gonna tell me that sine of theta is equals to X over 3. And now, how do I get rid of sine?
R sine.
So theta is going to be equal to R sine of X over 3. So what I can do here is write, this is minus cotangent of R sine of X over 3 minus R sine of X over 3 plus 2. That's my answer. So this integral that looks horrible is much easier if I change it to that. I mean, easier. I'm not saying easy, but it's easier. Okay, questions? Let's hope for the best. All right. So what's the derivative of tangent? not going to worry about that now. Now, over here, I'm just going to put integral over square root of theta squared of theta plus 1. And my dx, what am I doing? Tangent squared of theta plus 1. And over here, I have theta squared d theta. Correct? Check on me because then I start thinking on my motion and I forget what I'm doing. Is this right? Is this right?
Yep.
Okay. Alright, so what is tangent squared plus 1? So how does this reduce? It looks like tangent cube theta. And what is in the denominator? Now we have to integrate that, and then we have to go backwards. Because there are several changes here. So one of the changes is that I want to integrate, and this is what I give me, u cubed over 3 minus u plus a constant. But I'm not done, babies. I'm not done because u is equal to theta. Right? Agree? So this guy has to be replaced by secant of theta. So go back here and then we say this is equal to secant cube of theta over c minus secant of theta plus c. Am I done now? No, because what is theta? From this one, what is theta?
Over
X minus 3 is plus 7. And what I want to do is I want to divide it in two integrals. So I want to say this is equals to A over A, I don't know what X is, but I'm going to figure it out. A over X minus 3 plus B over the other factor, that is X plus 7. These have to be irreducible, meaning you cannot reduce these polynomials anymore. So these are irreducible polynomials. Oh, you cannot be factored anymore. That's the thing, that's the most that it can be factored. Okay? And now what I want to do here is I want to take common denominator. And if I want to take common denominator, as you know, that's what I'm saying, I'm not doing it and doing it again. So common denominator is the product of these two. So this is gonna be again x minus 3 times x plus 7. And then I check this common denominator with the first factor. And I said, what is missing? Oh, this guy is missing. So this should be 8 times x plus 7 plus, if I compare this with this, what is missing? X minus 3, so it should be plus 3 times x minus 3. And then I'm going to point that top and see what I get. Any questions?
Minus 3 times, instead of B, I write this, 2 minus 8. So this is equal to 5.
that is just algebra. So what do I get? I get 7a minus 6 plus 3a, is that right? Equals to 5. Yes? No? Yes? Yes. Alright, so I add whatever has that and I get 10a equals to 11, meaning a is equal to 11 over 10. And then I go for b. So b, and b is going to be equal to 2 minus 11 over 10. So what is this? 20 minus 11, 9 over 10. Yes? Okay, so now everything is easy. My integral became this. So my integral that looks like 2x plus 5 over x minus 3 and plus 7 became the two integral. Became the integral of, I just have to remember what was a. So a is over x minus 3, so 11 tenths over x minus 3 dx plus b, which is what? 9 over 10 over x plus 7 dx. And these are very nice and easy integrals because this is equal to what? The first integral is equal to what? Ln of x minus 3 plus 9 tenths over ln of x plus 7 plus 3. Nice and easy. Questions? Questions? Okay, when